Hi, it's D. Timothy. Welcome to another episode. Now, let's talk about Canaan... Wait, what? Let's talk about Canaan Heights. Usually, when one is looking for a home to buy, there are five major key points that they base on to judge whether a house or a home is good enough or it's not really good. And these are, one, the size of the house plus the rooms, because a spacious house is really just perfect. Then two, accessibility, that is how easy it is to access this home from maybe the main road, or how easy it is to drive from your home to town or any neighboring facility you would like to visit. The number three, the neighborhood, because no one wants to get a very good house in a war zone. When we're talking about the neighborhood, we're talking about your immediate neighbors, the people you stay with, and the neighbors outside your home. Which facilities do we have? Do we have noisy bars around, or we have maybe offices or other buildings that don't give out a lot of noise? Number four, we have the amenities. What does this property come with? Do we have a swimming pool? Do we have a gym, steam, sauna, anything around? Number five is how far the property is from town. Because most of us work from town, it's not really viable to get a property that is very far from town, and every day you have to go through the jam to reach home and go through the jam one more time to reach town. So those are the five key major points that we usually look at. But for Canaan Heights, I can't judge if it's really a good home or not, but one thing I know, it's just located on Windsor Crescent Road. Windsor Crescent is the road that connects from John Babiha or Acacia Avenue, and then it branches off right. So if when you're coming from Acacia while going down to Yusuf Lule Road, the turn that goes off, actually there is also Kaboja, I think it's Kaboja High or Kaboja Junior, I'm not so sure about that. But that's the road where Canaan Heights is located. Now, it comes with 3 bedroom plus 1 bedroom for the maid, which is self-contained, and 5 total bathrooms for every unit. Canaan Heights, Canaan Apartments, and the Golden Tulip, they all belong to the same family because they were constructed and they are being managed by the same company called the Canaan Ze Construction Uganda Limited. Now, looking back to the 5 points that we talked about earlier on, number one being the size of the home. For Canaan Heights, it offers spacious rooms, that is a spacious living room and a dining hall, then plus a spacious kitchen, plus a big master bedroom and 2 other rooms that are just big enough. Now, before you even enter the house, it also offers a spacious lobby. This lobby can act as maybe a kids' play area. That is in case you don't want your kids to play from the inside of the home. Or you can utilize it to be kind of like a working area and you set up a home office right there. Now, point number two, the distance from town is just good enough because Windsor Crescent, where this property is located, is just 7 minutes from Kampala City Square, which is like 2.5 kilometers. The same distance from Posta Uganda to, I think, Makerere Eastern Gate. And accessing it, there are a number of options. You can use Ginger Road, you can use Nakasero, you can also use Wandegia to connect to this place. For point number three, the neighborhood. This property is just located in the right location. The neighborhood is just perfect because it's next to a shopping mall, which is Acacia, next to a school, which is Kaboja, and then the golf course. And also, it's not that far from Kampala City Center because, like I say, it's only 2.5 kilometers. And you can be able to connect to town or any other place from Windsor Crescent very easily because there are a number of optional roads that you can use. Then, number four, which is the number of amenities this property comes with. It has a swimming pool, although it's a bit small, but it's good enough. Then it comes with a sauna. It has a steam bath. It has a standby generator. A parking for every unit comes with 2 allocated parking slots. And in total, there are 2 parking levels. Then it also comes with an elevator plus air conditioners for every unit. Then there is also smoke detectors and very many other accessories. Number five, which is accessibility, is kind of similar to the other point that I talked about for the distance from town, but it's very accessible because connecting from town to Windsor Crescent, there are like three or more options. You can use Ginger Road, you can use Wandegea, or you can even connect from Nakasero. So it's very accessible. Looking at this property, there's only one thing that I saw that can be improved, unfortunately, and it was the ground size, because this property where it's located, there's not so much space, so that is why we have a very small garden and a very small swimming pool. But on that, but still on the good side, the swimming pool is being catered for and the garden really looks nice, which is a good thing. So it's all about how you see it. But if you are expecting an Olympic size, no, you won't be able to get it from here. But everything else is just good enough. So that is like five good points against one. Like I said, in total there are 16 units, 8 units on every side of the block, plus one penthouse at the top, but the penthouse was already taken. A unit at Cannon Heights starts at $350,000. That is close to 1.2 billion Uganda shillings. And booking is already on. You can just check the description of this video for any information regarding the booking agent. And you will also be able to get our contact details in case you want to get back to us regarding this property. Anyway, that's it from my end. Just let me know what you think about this property in the comment section, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.